Good afternoon, and welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. Now, I do apologize on the last video. I noticed after I uploaded it and published it that I should have, there was a, you know, the speed up part when we were taking on that Bat Baron, and I forgot to actually edit out the sound and add in music, so I do apologize. But anyways, let's push on into this area. I have a feeling that, you know, something's about to happen.
An exorcist.
Did he slip and fall?
Oh.
No, he was thrown in.
Dun, dun, dun. Battle tutorial. Hitting all of an enemy's weak points during a combo will activate a weak point combo, greatly increasing your damage with each consecutive hit. Daemon Dial is weak against demihumans, fire, and earth, so Velvet's harsh rebuttal to Searing Edge to Tearing Thorn combo will activate a weak point combo. Alright. No, that's not, okay.
On to battle.
Oh, well.
We found our murderer. More fools from Hellebees came hunting me down, did you?
It seems that way.
Stay down!
For more!
Aha!
You're in my way!
You little... Huh?
I'll stop
you! Slow down!
Deception! Deception!
See this?
Deception!
See this? Deception! See this?
You
see, do you see this deception?
See this?
Slow down!
Deception!
You're in my way!
I meant to do...
Nope.
Down, down, up.
Slow down!
I'll stop you! See this?
It keeps blocking everything.
I'll stop you!
Slow down!
Deception!
Deception! Do you see this, deception?
See this?
Alright, now we're up to 5 souls already, so...
Turn one!
Give me human theronized!
You won't get a
deception!
Oh! That's a different one.
See this?
That I hadn't seen before. Okay. Looks like that was... I'm assuming that was maybe... I don't know, maybe not.
You're in my way!
I'll stop you!
That attack! It's like a big AoE stun.
See this?
So I'm assuming that Dial is just a bad apple.
You're in my way.
He can do that, like, even when he's being attacked. Unless we're getting, like, power hits on him.
I'll stop you. Deception.
Slow down.
Deception.
There we go. Tomorrow. Look at that combo. 35 hits.
Yes, please.
I won't die yet. Not until I have my revenge.
Revenge?
The bastards at the guild who tried to kill me. They want me to take the fall for their smuggling operation.
Wait, are you saying the whole guild was involved?
Of course. You think a second-rate sailor like me could pull off all that mischief by myself? I mean, sure, I was in on it. Helping them wasn't without its benefits.
He has a point. It would take more than one person to dig that tunnel into the warehouse.
Problem is, our extra-legal activities were a little too successful. The Abbey was bound to notice us at some point.
And dead men tell no tales. So they blame it on you and kill you to cover it up. Looks like it's not going quite how they planned.
How do you mean to get this revenge of yours?
A raid on Hellebees. I'll kill the lot of them. This I swear.
That would be suicide. Do you have any idea how many exorcists are around?
They'll hunt me down no matter what I do. I just want the guild to pay for what they did to me. That's all I wanted. But I guess even that's not gonna work out.
We'll take this back to town and tell him you're dead. That should be enough to satisfy the exorcists and get them to call off the search.
God.
But why?
I have my reasons. We need a boat fixed for starters. Plus, if you stir things up after I leave, I imagine it'll slow down anyone who's following me.
If that's what you want, miss, I won't let you down.
Man, just chopping off tails. Alright, we got a grade 11.3, form 2, imbue earth art learned. And a couple equipment masteries, amber boots, amber blade, Denor bottle. A curious potion that, inside a dungeon, instantly sends you to the entrance, as long as you've passed through it before. You can use a Denor bottle by pressing V while you're inside a dungeon. Using a Denor bottle will teleport you directly to the dungeon's entrance. You can get them from shops or from treasure chests. Very nice. And we got Dial's Tail. Oops.
By the way, how on earth did you find out where I was hiding?
Luck. And a solid hunch.
The village I grew up in was the dullest, gloomiest place ever. I hated it so much I became a sailor first chance I could get. But look at me now. If I could do it all again, I wouldn't abandon my home.
I see.
So, apparently, he's not bad then. He's just being set up and wants his revenge. Which it seems like the humans like really mistreat the demons. And then they're like, I wonder why they're attacking us. You know, it's like, that's the way of people, I guess. Lavender is extra 2 attack. We'll go ahead and pop that and we'll head on outside the dungeon. I'm not going to use that Denor bottle right now just because, I mean, we're right next to a warp spot. So I feel like it would be wasteful to just blow that Denor bottle.
Is this really how you want to play it?
Listen, I'm being hunted too. It's only a matter of time. I can't afford sympathy.
Alright. Oh, and we did, that's right. I don't think I have any other alternatives to the Amber Blade for her. I think I'm gonna go ahead and take the maximum HP Amber Belt. Let's see, where does this go? Right near the entrance. Okay, the entrance is right over this way. May have to fight a couple battles. Because if I recall, there was a couple mobs. Yeah, right out here. I'll probably bypass them. I feel like we're strong enough right now. I mean, we're only level 9, but I mean, we're pretty much, we may end up actually turning up the difficulty of the combat. That's also a possibility as well. We shall see. Go ahead and break that just to open up that shortcut. But I am going to go back through this town because there may be, you know, some new stuff or whatever. Seems like the cat spirits, like, come back or change over time or something like that. Because there's no way I missed one right next to the weapon dealer. Just stock back up on, like, prickle boar meat and some of that stuff. And it looks like there's nothing really of note around here. So I guess we'll head back. Oh, wow, all these cat spirits are back. Alright, I guess we're going to grab them then. Like, here's all of these. It might be a limited respawn. That's a possibility, I guess. Earned a new title, Devotee. What is this? Just running around. I'm not doing anything. title for one who has played the game for a length of time. Thanks for playing. Oh, for reaching 300 minutes. The next title is at 3,000 minutes. Capability versus beast plus 8% and decreases SG cost of arts based on their star level. Cured anchovy. Pickled to perfection for your pleasure. Used in Bazonga Veggie Bagnacotta. That is a name, I tell you what. That's so strange that these just respawn all the time. Copper coins. I mean, I don't know if that's going to be, you know, if they're going to end up getting so expensive to open that you're going to want to be picking all these up. Or maybe it's just limited time. Like, it'll maybe respawn 3 or 4 times or something like that. I don't know. somebody up here to talk to.
We're lucky the snow has been white for the past few years. Why is that lucky? Snow is always white. Wrong. In Helaviz, it isn't always. Depending on the direction of the wind and what the volcano is up to, volcanic ash can mix in with the snow and turn it gray.
There's a volcano nearby?
It's actually quite a ways up north, but it's the biggest volcano in all of Midgand. Mount Killerouse, it's called. And that's where we mine our Flamestone. Actually, it's the only place you can mine the stuff.
Mount Killerouse.
It's got a nice ring to it. You ever seen a volcano, Velvet?
No, and I'm not interested.
Well, I bet you we're gonna go see it at some point. Cat Spirit. So here's the guild. Bunch of jerks.
This is Dial's tale. Did you really kill him?
We found him dead in the Lake of Tar. This is all we could bring back.
Is that so?
You can doubt me all you like, but I brought you the demon's body. Who else can say that?
True enough.
Good. Get to work on my ship, then.
I'm afraid we can't. We still need Lady Teresa's permission first.
I'm in a hurry. It would be much worse for you if she knew who the real smugglers were.
You wouldn't!
It's a trade. Repair the ship on the beach, and I'll sail away quietly.
Very well. I'll find you your shipwrights. We'll see you at the shore.
All right.
Hey, Velvet. This would be a perfect opportunity for us to upgrade our equipment. How about it?
What are you talking about?
You don't know?
We didn't have anything like that in our village.
All the more reason, then. Come on, let's go.
Hey, you don't need to be so pushy.
That's just how I am. Get used to it. Come on.
Weapon upgrading. With the Novice Smith's Acerite, you can now enhance and dismantle equipment at shops. Enhancing a piece of equipment will improve its parameters and provide a chance of activating an enhancement bonus. You can obtain the materials necessary for enchantment by dismantling equipment. Let's start by enhancing a piece of equipment. Select Enhance from the menu. The Blood Blade. The materials required for enhancement are displayed on the lower left. In order to perform the enhancement, you must have all the required materials. It just requires one bronze scrap. In addition, the materials will also need gold to enhance equipment. The gold needed is displayed on the lower right. If you don't have enough gold, you won't be able to perform the enhancement. Since this is your first time enhancing, you can enhance a blood blade for free. Please select your blood blade from the equipment list. Enhance. Enhancement bonus, damage against stun foes, plus 10%. Because of the enhancement, your blood blade has improved and its enhancement level is now displayed with a plus 1 at the end of the item's name. Additionally, the enhancement bonus triggered, giving it a new skill. The limit for enhancement levels depends on the Acerite you use. The Novice Smith's Acerite allows you to enhance items up to plus 3. With other Acerite, you can enhance an item up to plus 10. Once a piece of equipment has been fully enhanced, its name will change and become gold. The amount and quality of materials needed to enhance an item increases with its rarity and the number of items it has already been enhanced, or the number of times, sorry. Higher quality enhancement materials can be gained by dismantling enhanced equipment. Through this cycle of enhancing and dismantling, you can create more powerful equipment. Now try dismantling equipment. Please choose dismantle from the menu. A list of your equipment is displayed on the left side of the screen. Equipment that can be dismantled appears in white. Items that are currently equipped or locked appear in gray and cannot be dismantled. When you select a piece of equipment for dismantling, the list of materials you will gain by dismantling that item will appear on the lower left. So if we dismantle the blood blade, we get 2 bronze scrap, an odorless fluid, and a coarse tempering powder. Now try dismantling the blood blade plus 1. There we go, we got all those things. The materials you gain from dismantling a piece of equipment depend on the enhancement level of that equipment as well as the skills attached to it. This ends the tutorial on enhancing and dismantling equipment. Use these techniques well to make your character stronger than ever.
And that's how it's done. Get it?
I suppose. It seems like kind of a hassle.
Maybe at first, sure. But once you get it down, it'll be second nature. You'll eventually learn how to maximize your personal strengths through wise upgrading and dismantling.
It does seem useful.
Right? If you plan to continue your crusade, upgrading may give you the edge you need. Of course, those who are inadequately prepared for battle probably won't end up on the winning side.
That's certainly true enough. And hey, if it'll make me stronger, I'm sure I'll figure it out. If it'll help me take him down.
It will indeed. And we consumed Isle's Tale and got the novices. That's all right. For smithing. So, I need to do a little bit of dismantling. So give me just a bit here. Oh, we got amber fragments from this stuff. Balmy fluid. Yeah, I'm going to dismantle this stuff like crazy. Weapons especially, because weapons are going to be... Actually, can we do... Okay, it's only weapons, it looks like. No, it isn't. Here we go. Here's all the rest of the stuff. But weapons especially, because they are, you know, character specific. Like her, she's mastered the Blood Blade. Alright, and then if we want to enhance... I'm going to enhance her... Amber Blade. Enhancement bonus, damage against stun foes, plus 10%. And we're going to go ahead and upgrade it again. And probably one more time. Takes a coarse tempering powder, though. That's fine. We're going to go ahead and upgrade it. I'm probably going to find... I'll bet you I find a new weapon, like, shortly. Chances are... There we go. So hers is plus 3 and his is plus 2. And we got a new title, Master Smith. A title for one who has enhanced a single item several times, one step at a time. Increases stagger duration of arts and capability versus beast, plus 10%. Alright. I'll probably do a bit more of that between this episode and next. I want to kind of work on the equipment and dismantle. I need to go through pretty much all the equipment. I'd like to keep one of like all the different armor and stuff, just so that we have it. You know, down the road, whenever we get more characters and stuff, I want to make sure that I have all the opportunities to maximize skills and like skill growth and all of that. So I am going to try to, you know, do all the equipment with everybody. So like boots and stuff, for example, you notice that, you know, multiple characters can wear those. So I want to kind of switch it up and maybe get all that stuff maxed for everybody.
Well, it looks like we'll get the repairs we need.
Maybe, but that's only half of our problem. Without a proper crew, we'll wind up shipwrecked again.
We don't have time to find one, and we can't hire a ship without permission.
We'll just have to do what we can. But we've seen where my sailing skills get us.
I'm not forcing you to come. I'll do it alone if I have to.
I wonder if there are any free sailors around.
That is a good question. And I still wonder what happened to Maggie Lou, because she went off on her own like forever ago, and then we haven't heard or seen her at all. So, man, those cat spirits, like three right out the gate right there, it adds up extremely quickly. So I'm not really for sure if I need to just keep heading on this way or head back towards the ship. Alright, so up ahead is the ship.
Hey, Velvet, do the demons you kill turn back into humans?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Remember the demon that attacked us near the coast? When it died, it turned back into a human. Every demon I've killed has stayed a demon. So, I was just wondering what was different.
Do demons stay demons when they die? But what about Nico and the villagers I killed?
Maybe it's just a case-by-case sort of thing.
Who cares? A corpse is a corpse, whether it's human or demon.
Yeah. I guess being human again doesn't help much if you're already dead.
Exactly. All that matters is that the demons I devour make me stronger. Nothing more.
Alright. So here is the boat. So are we going to be able to get this thing fixed? I see people over there. Yeah, okay. We'll go have a chat with them, I guess.
She's hopeless. Her keel's busted. It'd be faster to build a new ship.
Her keel?
You could say she's like a man with a broken back. And how in blazes did you end up running aground here? I wouldn't think it possible.
If you can't help, that's enough. Go back to town.
What now? Do we try to find a new ship?
I can't think of anything else. I just hope we have time.
Huh. Uh-oh. Oh, Empyrean Innominat, hear my prayer. Blessings and honor unto thee. This frail flesh a sacrifice to be thy foundation.
Sister.
Oh, Oscar! What brings you here? Your face! What happened to you?
A demon got the better of me. I've been summoned back to the Abbey, but I thought I'd stop by on my way.
My poor brother. I'm so sorry.
There is pain, but I can still fight. The scar will serve to remind me of my inexperience.
An underhanded foe, no doubt.
No. The demon saps her enemy's strength with her left hand and turns it against them. It was a girl with black hair and eyes full of fire. She poses a threat for even a seasoned praetor. Please, take care, dear sister.
Uh-oh.
It was her!
Teresa?
Understood. I will. Worry not. A failure as minor as this is not the end of the world.
To be honest, I came hoping you would cheer me up like that. Well, I do believe I recognize those earrings.
Of course. I treasure them dearly. Thank you.
It's like the Lannisters up in here.
They suit you just as well as I thought they would. I must take my leave now.
Lady Teresa, we've captured a stowaway.
Uh-oh.
I wasn't stowing away, you twit! I merely boarded without permission!
You! You're a collaborator with that demon woman. Where is she?
Your tortures are useless against the mighty Mogilu! Because I'll spill my guts just fine without him.
Uh-oh. So, I wonder if Mogilu is actually going to betray us or not. I can tell that one woman, you know, the sister to that brother that we beat the crap out of before. I can tell that she's not terribly happy about us anymore. not just the fact that we're demons, but now she has a personal vendetta against us, which, I have a feeling we're not going to have a happy welcome when we get back to town. But, yeah. I just wonder if Mogilu is actually betraying us, or maybe she's trying to throw them off of our trail or something like that, you know. I guess we will find out. Alright, apparently there's a star right up here at the gate. What are these guys doing?
There was word from the Abbey. They're holding a public execution for a witch who tried to draw demons into the city.
Is that so? Sounds like a real nasty character.
I'd stay away from the city if I were you. It's a common tactic for Lady Teresa. Threaten one criminal to draw out their allies.
Are you saying I'm a criminal? Pot calling the kettle black, isn't it?
That's why I'm warning you. Lady Teresa's top class, even among exorcist praetors. I wouldn't think badly of you if you fled.
A witch. It has to be Mogilu, huh?
It looks like the Abbey is on to us. We'd best assume they've already found the tunnel.
No sense trying to buy a ship now.
Then don't buy one. Steal it.
Steal a ship from Helavise. Just the two of us.
We have at least one other on our side.
Dial?
He said he can navigate. If he joins forces with us, all the better.
That could be. But what happens to Mogilu?
I suppose that's up to the Abbey.
All right.
Let's head to Dial's cave.
Okay. Sorry, Mogilu. Rest in peace.
Sorry, you're dead. Alright, we'll head up the shortcut path, I guess. Nope, a villain's approach.
You really go all out, don't you?
What do you mean?
Look, you're using Dial, threatening the guild, abandoning Mogilu. You see?
I'm not abandoning her. She can take care of herself.
Nothing stops you, does it?
There's a lot I don't understand about Mogilu, but I know she won't be killed so easily. Besides, I'm sure she's already told the Abbey everything she knows about us.
You're probably right.
That means we need an ace up our sleeve. Like a demon they believe to be dead.
Maintaining blades.
Alright. One last good sharpening and I'll call this blade done. Do your blades need sharpening too? I'd be happy to take care of it for you if you want.
No thanks. I was taught never to leave my lifeline in the hands of another.
Sure. Sounds like you found a good teacher. I don't care if it's me who does it, as long as you're keeping them well maintained. Just in case you don't already know, after you sharpen your blades, you should rub them with clove oil and wipe them down with wool.
Yeah, I know. I was taught that too. By the man who killed my brother.
I just wonder if it's as simple as all that, you know? Like... I don't know. I feel like there's gonna be... You know, I feel like in this game there's probably gonna be a lot of, like, twists. As we go through it, you know. We'll see. But so far it's already been... a bit of a roller coaster. I have to say. Alright, Mr. Dial.
What are you two doing back here?
Things didn't work out. We'll lend a hand with your raid.
Awfully presumptuous, aren't you?
I'm a demon. Comes with the territory.
You got me there. Ah, gods. I think that's the first time I've laughed since turning demon. But are you sure? It's suicide, you know.
Maybe not. I have a plan. The exorcists have a hostage they're using to lure me into the city.
Then we can sneak in through the tunnel into the storehouse.
No. I expect they'll have an ambush ready there. So instead, we hit them with a direct frontal assault.
You call that a plan?
No. I call it a feint. As their forces converge on the front, a second group slips in via the tunnel, strikes the docks, and secures a ship. After that, the two groups meet up and we all sail away. And I want you at the helm.
Answer me this, then. Who's making this frontal assault of yours?
I will, naturally.
That works. When?
Tomorrow. Can we rest here until then?
Make yourself at home. Nothing so comfy as a bed of tar.
Velvet? Hey, Velvet! Luffy? You were crying out. Were you having a nightmare? I was... Oh, Luffy! It was terrible! Hey, come on! Let go of me! I have to go! I have something important to do.
What's that?
Arthur told me to come meet him at the Shrine of Tranquility.
No, Luffy said! No! Listen to me! Artorias is... He's going to...
Are you all right? You were tossing and turning.
I'm fine. It was just a dream. If you don't want to go with me, I understand.
That wouldn't do. How can I repay you if you die?
You are an odd one.
Am I? I always thought of me as just me. Velvet, who's this Artorias?
My target. He killed my brother.
We're ready. Dial should be at the entrance.
Let's get going then.
Such good, like, character development in this one. Like, I mean, it's like Luffy said, we knew him for like 2 episodes, not even that, and he was just like dead. But like, And normally I'm not one, I don't tend to like little kid type characters, you know. They're kind of like, kind of get tired of them.
Just fine, thanks. And your special concoction?
Ready for deployment anytime. By the way, I never caught your name.
Velvet.
We'll sail together if you live, Velvet. If not, at least I know what to put on your tombstone.
You've got a sharp tongue.
I've always been that way.
Right then, we're off to attack Helavies.
Alright, that reminds me.
That reminds me. Where do you think that boy who took the compass ran off to?
Helavies, I'd imagine. Since Malakim are always tethered to exorcists.
That means we might run into him during our attack.
Are you getting squeamish about killing the boy because you feel indebted to him for healing you?
No. If he gets in the way, I'll take him down. But...
But?
I have to remember to thank him first.
Right.
Does that bother you at all?
No, not really. I just know that Malakim don't taste very good.
Malakim don't suit your palate? I'll call that a positive.
Alright, I was just looking at the time on the video. It is just about wrapping up point, which seems like a fairly good point to actually stop the video, because I have a feeling things are about to get absolutely crazy. So, I guess next episode, when we come back, we're going to attack Helavies. And then hopefully get a ship and head out, I suppose. And hopefully we can rescue Mogilu, and maybe she'll actually join our group. So, and I'm still wondering about that little kid. I really think that that is Lafayette. So hopefully we'll find out more about him next episode as well. Oh, but we will prepare for war. So I'm going to do a bit of grinding between this episode and next, probably in the cave here. This is actually a fairly good place to stop, because I can step into there, I can grind, I can go back out, go to the inn, that kind of stuff. Maybe grind up a few levels on both of them before we attack Helavies next episode. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, as always, be sure and hit that like button and go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. And I hope you guys join me for next time. So until then, as always, do take care, stay safe, and we will see you next time.